When it comes to serial killers, a lot of us are very intrigued by the concept of understanding exactly why they do what they do. And it's something that, you know, people are very interested in understanding, because to get inside the mind of a serial killer and sort of understand what drove them to do what they did is something that maybe we'll never ever understand. But psychologists have different categories for different types of killers, and even though Scream's fiction, I want to do some fun videos for you guys by assessing the killers in Scream individually and explain to you guys which category I think they fall in. And in this video, the first killer we're going to be assessing is Billy Loomis. Hello everyone, and welcome to Beyond the Mask, where we talk about all things Scream. If you're interested in Scream content, or you just like Ghostface in general, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and make sure you hit the bell icon to stay notified for future content. I've been wanting to do a video like this for some time, I'll be honest with you. I'm really interested in psychology on serial killers, and it's something that I've researched quite heavily and studied quite a lot in the past, and the whole notion of understanding why people do what they do, especially when they're doing something so horrific as murder, is something that's always really intrigued me, and I hope that you guys enjoy this video. I just want to say as well, before I get into this, I know these characters are fiction and there's no actual evidence to suggest that this is actually true, but I just wanted to sort of give you guys a fun video to sort of understand what kind of killer, you know, Billy Loomis is, and understand why he did what he did, and also maybe shed some depth on the character, because even though we saw bits about the movie and we saw elements that may suggest he is in a category of killer, there's some parts of the category he falls in which may actually shed some light on why he ended up the way he did. So without further ado, let me get straight into this by saying that psychologists have four different categories for killers, right? So the categories are this: power and control, visionary, mission orientated, and thrill seeker. There's actually different variations of killers, and it goes quite in depth if you start studying them. And even though Billy is actually in one of these categories, which I will get into in a sec, you'd be surprised to know that some of the killers in the Scream universe are actually quite different from each other, and their ways and understandings of killing are actually completely different to how Billy was, and that may surprise you. But if you're interested in these kind of videos, you know, I'm going to be doing some more, and I will explain each killer for you to give you an understanding of exactly how this works. So let me get back into the video. I just want to point out very quickly that a visionary killer is someone who believes they're being commanded to kill by a higher entity. Visionary killers aren't actually planners, so they may just pick one person, start them, and then kill them. So a mission killer, they sort of target a specific group of people, and they can do that sort of in ways of attacking homosexuals or people of colour, and their kills are usually quick and efficiently, according to psychologists. And a power killer is someone who will rape, torture, and mutilate their victims. And then a thrill killer is someone who murdering somebody excites them, and they enjoy the hunt and get off on the victim's terror. Billy Loomis was a very interesting case in this, because some of these killers in Scream may fall into multiple categories, and that's one of the things that I find quite interesting, is that, you know, that can happen. Some killers do fall into multiple categories, but the main category that Billy falls into is a thrill killer. So as a thrill killer, the reason why Billy falls into this category is because a thrill killer tends to sort of enjoy just murdering people, and it's not for any kind of lust, or it's not for any kind of higher power. It's just purely because they enjoy killing. And what they tend to do is, and I will read this to you directly from the writings given by a psychologist in America, who said that witnessing their victim's fear gives them a high that they find extremely pleasurable. In other words, the suffering of their victim excites them. This is the type of killer who will murder someone just so they can know how it feels. It is the act itself that motivates them. Because this type of serial killer gets a pleasure out of seeing their victims suffer, sadism can be a common factor in their crimes. For example, they may torture their victims both physically and mentally. They might let their victim run so they can chase after them. They may also verbally taunt them or go through extra steps in order to scare them. So essentially, thrill killers feed off the response they get from their victim. And I just wanted to say that this is pretty obvious to me, that this is the kind of killer that Billy was. He enjoyed calling his victims up. He enjoyed, you know, the fear that they gave off and the terror that it gave them. He enjoyed taunting Casey Becker on the phone because he enjoyed the fact that she was terrified. And then also, another thing that people say about hedonistic thrill killers is that they also enjoy physical contact. So they tend to be more into strangling their victims, or they enjoy stabbing their victims with a knife. They don't enjoy any other weapons other than a knife because they prefer the personal contact. And a knife to a hedonistic killer feels more personal. And one of the primary things that gives Billy away is the fact that he does strangle his victims when he starts getting into that moment. And that's the personal touch that hedonistic thrill killers actually go for. The strangling of a victim is something that they enjoy doing. Now, something else that psychologists actually say, which may help you sort of understand the kind of character that Billy was, because even though we sort of get a lot in the Scream movies, there's not a whole lot of depth to understand things by. And that's one of the things that, you know, they didn't need a lot of depth in them. You know, us as fans can sort of piece things together on our own. But one thing I wanted to point out was one thing that I actually read a long time ago when I was studying this kind of stuff, was that thrill killers tend to appear normal and confident on the outside in public. To the general public, they can appear pretty normal, and you'd probably think there's no way that they could be a killer. But also, some psychologists say that something traumatic can happen in their life that sort of makes them feel inadequate or powerless. And in majority of cases, when a hedonistic thrill killer has killed somebody, they may walk away from it for a while, but once they've killed one person, it tends to become a craving that they want to do it again. But the interesting thing with Billy is that if you take notice, adding into the whole comfort aspect and close contact, he targeted Sydney and wanted revenge for what happened between his parents. And just think about the psychological aspect overall. Even though the kill is close contact, how much closer in contact can you be to someone who's your target than being in a relationship with them? You know, he enjoyed being so close to Sydney that he could manipulate her and then plan to kill her. She was Billy's obsession. Are you as intrigued into the psychology of serial killers as I am? I really hope you are, because I'm going to be doing more of these videos to sort of explain individually which killer was which. Even people like Stu and Charlie as well, they're going to be getting videos to explain what kind of killers they were, because some were similar, but a lot of them had different motives. And if you sort of assess how they killed, even though a lot of people sort of copied Billy's pattern, their actual ways and needs for killing were so different. That's something that I hope you guys are going to be really interested in watching. So thank you very much for watching this video, guys. Don't forget to like this video, because that always helps this channel out. And if you want to join our Scream community, head over to the community section on this channel to take part in discussions and vote in polls all relating to Scream. And it seems only fitting to leave this video on a Billy quote. Without further ado, let's hand over to my personal favorite killer in the Scream franchise.
It's all a movie. It's all one great big movie.
Like scary.